Hey guys, it's Art Weston. I'm going to be doing an abrasion test today against three different lines that are roughly the same diameter. The first one is Berkeley's Fireline Ultra 8 Carrier in 30 pound. I had a previous video where I tested its breaking strength and it breaks at 82 pounds, which is unusual for 30 pound line, but it really just isn't 30 pound line. So it's just way underrated, likely for marketing purposes or otherwise. An equivalent to that is Seaguar's 60 pound threadlock 16 strand hollow core. This one breaks at 87 pounds, so 82 pounds versus 87 pounds, which is very similar. And then I wanted to compare it against the copolymer, so this is the Suffix Tritanium Plus in 20 pound. So, and it breaks at roughly 30 pounds, but it's about the same diameter as the other two braided lines. So, in essence, this is a 30 pound line, this is 82 pound line, and this is 87 pound line of roughly the same diameter. So, the abrasion test, the reason why I'm doing it is because the Fireline is advertised as one of the most abrasion resistant braided lines because it's fused, which is some type of process, right, to take the carriers and combine them in a way that kind of creates more of a single filament feeling line where you can't really separate the different eight carriers easily. And I don't know if they do that via some material because it feels waxy, so it might be something simply to do with they've added something like wax or something equivalent to that. The 16 carrier on the thread lock, reason why it's 16 carriers is because it's hollow core, which allows you to thread in monofilament fluorocarbon leaders or to create a loop that you can use for other types of connections. So my guess is the copolymer is going to win just because classically copolymer tends to do quite well. And then of course, out of the two braided lines, my guess would be the Fireline would come in second because it's fused and it has that coating. But I have all three lines all set up. I got a little cannonball weight ready to go. I've got my device here that I use for abrasion resistance. And it simply is the ability for the line to withstand and the number of rotations on this crank. So I'm going to start with what I'm going to guess is the weakest line, which is the thread lock, because it's the 16 carrier with no coating. Place that weight there, and then again I'm just going to count the number of rotations, and you guys can watch as well. And when the weight drops, we'll count it. One. So it's between 7 and 8 turns, okay? So 7 to 8, right, for the thread lock. And then let's go to the Fireline. Okay, ready? 1, 2, 3, 4. 11, so 7 to 8 for the first one, 11 for the second, which is better, as I think we expected. Now let's try the copolymer. All right, so the copolymer got a rating of 36. We got 7 to 8 for the Seaguar and about 11 for the Fireline. So I think it is true that the Fireline is more abrasion resistant, I guess at least compared to one other line sample, but it's not nearly as abrasion resistant as copolymer. So anyway, interesting study. Thank you guys.